Recently, one of my IVF patients expressed concern to me that using a higher dose of fertility medications to mature the eggs would cause the embryo quality to be lower or make it more likely to have an embryo with chromosome abnormalities. Is there any truth to this fear? Let's find out. People who understand IVF know that it is a numbers game. The more eggs you can get, the more embryos that you make, the higher the chances for finding normal embryos, which may be able to produce a healthy live-born baby. To that end, the most successful IVF patients are those that are able to retrieve a larger number of eggs. Some people, however, do not respond well to fertility medications for a variety of reasons. I talk about that in this video. Because of these problems, these people who don't respond well to fertility medications generally have poorer egg quality, embryo quality, and a lower overall chance for pregnancy. It is these same people, however, that require higher doses of fertility medication. This has led some people to mistakenly believe that it is the higher dose of fertility medications that cause these problems, rather than the problems resulting in needing a higher dose of medications. A few years ago, scientists and physicians in California decided to study whether high doses of fertility medication affect embryo quality. They studied nearly 800 IVF cycles in which chromosome testing of the embryos was planned. In 184 IVF cycles, patients did not produce any normal embryos. A total of 519 patients had at least one normal embryo, and 506 of them had a total of 651 frozen embryo transfers of a single normal embryo. Patients were divided into three groups based on the dose of medication they took: low, medium, or high. They also divided them into four groups based on the number of eggs retrieved: 1 to 5 eggs, 6 to 10, 11 to 15, or more than 15. And they divided them into four age groups: less than 35 years old, 35 to 37, 38 to 40, and 41 and above. Here are the results. As expected, younger patients produced more normal embryos than older patients. In fact, the older the patient, on average, the less normal embryos were made. However, when each group was analyzed based on the dose of medication they took, there was no difference. For example, patients who were under the age of 35 produced the same percentage of normal embryos whether the dose of medication they took was low, medium, or high. The same was true for patients in the other age groups. Higher doses of medications did not make it more likely to produce abnormal embryos in any age group studied. The same was true when they looked at the number of eggs retrieved. Regardless of the medication dose, people who produced a lot of eggs had the same rate of normal embryos as people who produced few eggs. This study also looked at the appearance of the embryos under the microscope and could also not find any difference in the so-called embryo quality between people using low, medium, or high doses of fertility medication. Finally, they assessed the pregnancy rates when a single, chromosomally normal embryo was transferred. As expected, the chance for pregnancy was similar regardless of the medication dose. One important point to make here: all of the embryo transfers in this study were performed using frozen embryos. Some people have worried that high fertility medication doses may have an adverse effect on the uterine lining instead of the embryo. This study did not look at that possibility. By performing frozen embryo transfers, they were able to remove any influence of the uterine lining on pregnancy rates and conclude that the embryos were not affected. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: if you are a poor responder and your doctor recommends that you use a higher dose of fertility medication, you don't have to worry that it will have a negative effect on your embryo quality or chances for having normal embryos. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.